Hello, Tabertal. We are Friska Viljor. I'm Joachim, and this is
Daniel.
So, what do you want to ask us?
How did you like your gig here on Friday? You were one of the first bands.
The people were far away. It was the stage, and then a lot of space, and then it was the audience. So it was a bit strange, but it was still very nice playing, looking at the castles and the whole valley. It was very nice.
So I noticed I saw you for the third time this year here in Germany. Why are you at the moment so popular in Germany? Do you have an explanation for like that? Is it the IKEA phenomenon?
Yes.
You say yes, I say no. You say hi,
tomatoes,
I say too
say
low.
Tomatoes.
Yes. No, I think it's because we have played here so much. We played like 200 shows in Germany and around Germany. So I think we deserve a good popularity so far because we've played so much and we've earned it with our sweat and with our tears and with our blood. So I think that's why.
What's the good thing about festivals for you?
The food.
Food is good, yeah.
So we're here in your backstage room and it looks a little messy. So what's the most important thing in a backstage room? Is it the drinks, the food, girls, your manager?
Actually, it's the food. Of course, it's the food. Second is the girls. And third is the massage. Fourth is the flowers and ornaments in the backstage room. Fifth is that there's really good glasses. Sixth is that there has to be one champagne. Sixth is there has to be a room where we can close.
Yes.
Seventh is
be a mirror.
Mirror. So
there has to be
a lamp. And then it's girls and like it's drinks in ninth or tenth yes. place. Yeah.
So what kind of food do you like backstage the most? So what's your dream for a backstage food?
Good food.
For example?
Lasagna.
I haven't tried this.
That's really good, like ravioli, something.
This, but with a lot of butter on it, I guess would be really nice. I haven't tried it yet, but...
It is nice.
Yeah, so... Oh, heter
it's like vegetarian ravioli or something like that.
Yeah.
It's really
but
nice.
With butter.
And I would like to have like a big whole fried pig with an apple in his mouth. Like going like that.
Over fire.
Yeah, being alive when you start and being really good cooked when you end.
So back to your home country, Sweden. So why does Sweden bring up so many good bands compared to other countries? Because there are not so many people in Sweden, but tons of good bands. Why?
ABBA.
ABBA yeah. is the key for that? Why?
I heard you said BABBA.
BABBA.
BABBA was a bad answer, ABBA was a good answer.
ABBA is the key because it was the first really an international successful band in Sweden, and it made all of us like we are always like we don't think we're anything, but it made us think that we could be something.
Yeah, I mean, there's a thing in Sweden called Jante, which is like the roof where it stops. You could go there, but not further. But then ABBA raised the roof, like from there to really high.
So what will be the next big thing from Sweden besides Friska Viljor? Which is not popular at the moment in Germany or Central Europe. Do you have any recommendations?
Yeah, William the Contractor. That's really... That's a well-kept secret that I don't know. I still don't know if he will have the guts to release his stuff. But if it does, it will be a
What's his name?
Revolution.
William the Contractor.
Okay.
He hasn't released anything yet. He's on MySpace and like MySpace / William the Contractor.
Yeah, but he has one song there, and that's not his key song. I mean, he makes grown up men cry.
That's good. So, what are your plans after Taubertal Festival tomorrow and the next days?
Tomorrow it's Dockville in Hamburg.
You have a special relation to Hamburg because of your song Wohlwildstraße. Why?
We started out there. I mean we did the the cliché down in Hamburg. We went down to do have a vacation / play some street music. Went home and then got an email from a label there 2 weeks later that wanted to release our records because we played some songs in the streets. So it's, and then we met a lot of nice people that took care of us and showed us a lot of love. And we didn't give them anything and they gave us everything. It was... I've never experienced anything like that in my life before. It was vad heter givmildhet?
Like
generous people like I've never seen before.
So Hamburg is your home away from home?
No. Because we spent 3 months in Berlin this year. And I don't know, I can't speak for Joachim, but I came to love Berlin in such a way that I once or twice a week are standing in my shower kind of almost crying about not living there anymore. But those two cities have different places in my heart. I really like Germany as a whole, and both Hamburg and Berlin is brilliant cities.
Agreed.
That's good. So have fun tonight here at the Taubertal Festival, and thank you for the interview.
Thank you.
And Rothenburg is a great town as well, but smaller.